Okay, now there it is. Okay, thank you so much, Brow. I don't know why it keeps redoing that every time you want to get back into stuff, but appreciate it. Yeah, I don't know why I wasn't reverting back to my regular microphone. I don't know what happened there, but appreciate it. Thank you. I definitely would have been, like, the whole stream without really seeing it. Goddamn. Definitely coming in clutch there. This is bad. That's not good. At least to lower it a little bit. Oh, okay. That wasn't so bad then. We'll get you to heal real quick, sure. How you doing, bro? Thanks again. Oh, they do like... I don't have anything that'll do it. So what's the best play? Do we just swap for other people? Yeah, just to guarantee that we stay alive, I guess. I guess we could Lunarang or Lunar Shield. Yeah, play defense. Oh, they can stack, actually. Oh, look at that. I didn't know that. Oh, they kill themselves. Oh, nice. Oh, that's not nice, though. Okay. Well, down. Shit. And then we just do... I'm gonna swap for you. Then we're gonna ultimate, yeah. So that way we can heal at the same time. That's a full heal too. Oh yeah, that was really nice. Okay. Wow. That was fast. Holy shit, he does a lot of damage, but that was quick. Damn. Cool. Good stuff. And there's the last conch. Empty. It's empty. Hey, are you in there? What was the point of all this? Man, where the fuck was Sean at? What a waste of time. Surely the Great Alchemist had good reasons to lead us here. Getting rid of that threat, perhaps. Hey, hun. Oh, sure, I'll put it on. There you go. Arthur Work Cork. Really? He just had it on him the whole time? Always so full of surprises. Let's just go. So is that like his best? Yeah, that's his best item. Yeah, okay. So that kind of gives everybody, yeah, everybody now has, like, the best equipment as far as, like, offense goes. So, I'm not going to go and retrieve the last, conch. Only reason being, oh, wow, really? Apparently, like, for the true ending of the game, you need to, well, for streaming purposes, we'll do the regular ending, and then the true ending you get after that. I don't want to, like, interfere with the regular ending, I guess. I don't know how that really works. I guess I would be fine no matter what, but I just want to play it safe and not really do anything yet. So I'll retrieve the conches once that's all done, and then we'll finish that up after. Use a good amount of items, too. Damn. That little slug thing, like, damage-wise was really high, but I thought we were gonna go for, like, an even longer haul than that. Alright, so this is pretty much going into, like, the last bit of the regular game. Pretty sick that we got this far. We're going to definitely get some cooking done. Yeah. We're just gonna... Here's KO and 100%. Yeah, we're just gonna make two breezes, yeah. It literally makes no sense not to. Alright, then we're gonna rest, we're gonna save it. And then we'll take the necessary steps to get the true ending of the game. I did look up how to get, like, apparently there's, like, a secondary additional little secret that does involve doing, like, the, what is it? The champions thing, like, the game. I don't think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm just gonna, like, see what that little thing is on my own time, but the true ending of the game, I think you just get, like, while we're doing or whatever we're doing. So, I think we'll just do that, and then, I guess, progress from there. I don't know. I'll see how I feel, but I guess I don't know what comes beyond this screen now. Let's get it. Okay, a little blue balls there. I thought we were going straight into the boss, but I guess we get a Ganondorf going up the staircase with the piano type of situation. Cool little spire, though. Let's make sure also that we have all, like, the best equipment for everybody. Yeah, I think I sold everything. Attack power plus 4. Magic defense. Magic attack. Yeah, he's good with that. She has... increased bonus on timing hits. Yeah, plus 10%. Attack power plus 4. Attack power. Her attack is already kind of high. Let's add the magic attack instead. And for Rashan, he has the MP and the HP, so he gets a little bit more beefy. Max attack, max defense, regular attack. Yeah, alright, I'm fine with that. Yeah, it's a fucking long-ass tower. Feels like FF7 going up those staircases. Okay, there we go. You made it. Congratulations. You have been quite the nuisance. Prepare yourself. Prepare myself? My foolish child, fighting Solstice Warriors is beneath me. But you did make it all the way up here, so I will play by the rules. The time has come to decide on the fate of your realm and all of its worlds. Can you defeat my strongest lieutenant? Or will she reign supreme over the cyborgs? Never! Your evil has no place here anymore. My, haven't we grown boastful? Let the matter be settled then. I call on you, my champion. Destroy these interlopers, and claim your rightful place as ruler of this world. Come, Elysian Darrell. Ooh. Venus Man the Peen something. What's up, my man? Dude, I'm so sorry to hear what happened to your ACL, man. I hope that gets resolved and recovered really soon, man. Yeah, all right. She's cool. This design, at least. Erlina. What have you become? Who dares challenge my reign? She looks like a fucking... She looks like she would belong in, like, a Souls game, too. I like that design a lot. Don't you recognize us? I recognize Solstice Warrior Vermin. Vermin which must be eradicated. She's completely gone. Silence. You will bow before me. Brace yourselves. Alright, let's get it. Already she's going off rip, so we're gonna just play defense. You have a pre-op appointment on the 5th? Good luck, dude. For real. Okay, that was really graft and boring. We're just gonna bypass that. Swap back to you. Let's check out the damage. I'm doing okay. I can't complain right now. We're doing all right. We're gonna destroy it again because that just does both. Stop that. I should have waited, honestly, like, now that I see that. Damn. Yeah, that's not that bad damage at all. No multi-hitting, things for that. Well... I can't do anything about this, so... We'll just shield up. Telekinesis crash. Well, yeah. It took away two of those, goddamn. You bitch. Oh man, you're such an ass. Well, I can lower it at least. That sucks. Well, let's see what the actual damage is. That's not that much at all. Oh, it stabbed twice. Oh, damn. Missed that. Sure. Why not? We'll get one more look at the Vesper team. Once again, I can't really do much about it. Pyramid. Oh, it's that attack, right. It's, again, not that bad at all. Holy smokes. I can get past this, yeah. Well, you swap, actually. Yeah. Combo. Actually, wait. You swap. Yeah, there you go. Oh, cool. I need more Virgil. I need more. You suck. Oh my god. Okay. Second phase time. What do we got? Hey. Oh, that's cool. It's like dimension shifting too. Oh, that's pretty dope, actually. I like that. Yeah, I can get past this. Yeah, let's see. You do that. Okay, so it's got three strikes on that one. Oh, she can switch it up. Okay, gotcha. We're gonna put the defense on for now. I didn't even bother to check, like, if you could hit, like, the arms or anything. There we go. Then that. I'm taking it slow, though. I really don't mind, like, going the slow route. Okay. That was really good, actually. Ah, I missed the last one. Well, wonder what I'm doing. I'm not seeing any of your attacks. I don't give a shit. I have a plan here, actually. Delay it even further. Wow, and that killed it. Oh, that was cool. The way that I just don't let her fucking attack that whole time. That was pretty cool. Just don't let him play like the Dante Infinite. Dang, I get smoked. My power. Master, you promised. I promised opportunity. Nothing more. Oh. Hey! Oh. Now he's here. Fucking bitch ass. They've won. It's time to leave, after all. Oh, come on. I want to be there when they see the final surprise. What are you on about? Pfft. Ask your new guardian gods. Can you feel it? It's coming from so far away. A world eater. You are the only ones who can destroy it. Godspeed, Luana and Solon. You just... What the fuck is his problem? He's really gone. We're free. Hope. It's been so long. Valor. Zale. We must go now, Sarai. The World Eater has to be stopped. Will you return? We can feel everything now. There's just so much for us to do. So many worlds. I had no idea. This is goodbye, then? I guess so, Best. Wait! What's up, Teeks? Before you go, could I just... Right. It's been great knowing you. I'll make sure future generations know your story and remember you always. It's been great knowing you as well, Teeks. Please stay safe. It's not about us anymore. You take good care of yourselves and your people, okay? We'll do our best. In your memory. It's time to go, Valor. And so our watch begins. Here's hoping it won't be too boring. That'd be a first. Hey, don't forget to visit whenever you fly by. You bet. Fighting by your side has been my life's honor. Farewell. Oh, wow! That just goes straight to credits? Oh, wait a minute. What the hell? What is that? What the fuck? Yo, wait a minute. What? It becomes a fucking, like, Ikaruga? Yo, chill out. Wait, what? Well, I did want to play a bullet hell at some point. But hey. Super beam. Oh, wow. What the hell, dude? Man, get this shit out of here, bro. I fucking... This shit is free. Nope, nope. Mm-mm. I played much worse bullet hells than this. Oh, you can actually shoot those too as well. Okay. That's really not bad at all. Huh. Dodge that shit. God damn, yo, that's fucking... Am I gonna do this flawless? Yo, chill out. Okay. Well, super beam, because you got iframes. That's how you do it. Raiden? I played Raiden. Hell yeah. Raiden's awesome. Ikaruga's awesome. There's another one I forget the name of. Damn, I have to, like, see gameplay of it, because I kind of forgot, like, what you start off with in that game. Kind of, I don't actually want to play them on stream or anything, but they are sick as hell games to play. Just because they're just fucking cool, like, how quickly. Oh, no, I got hit! No! Oh, you can dive? Damn it, why did you tell me now? Oh, this game's fucked up. Huh? Why didn't it tell me the fucking mechanics now? It's bullshit! Whatever. Damn, I got hit once. Damn, I could have done that flawless. Oh, well. No, I didn't think I was done. I just thought, like, I was done with, like, the first part. Like, the ending, you know? I thought that we were going straight into, like, credits. And then, like, the extended part, like, the true ending was after that. Well... I mean, I should go through the credits now and, like, talk about the game, like, as a whole here. I feel like I should do that after the true ending, right? I think I'll do that after the true ending, because we're doing that tonight anyway. We may as well. And that was, like, very short credits anyway, so I wouldn't have been able to, like, get through it all. He's a ooh. Okay, well, actually, you could, because... Okay, I thought it was, like, doing, like, a little tease thing. Alright, well, fuck it. Unless I have anything else to, like, say after these credits and then, like, the next credits, if they come up at all, or after the true ending, I guess I'll just detail of what I'm thinking about now. Yeah, no, Sea of Stars is fantastic. No, this is a great fucking game. This is just, like, a continuation of how you can see greatness from... how well you can perceive, like, your childhood. And what I mean by that is Messenger was made by these games, by this company as well. And that game was incredible. And I love Messenger to death. And it's just retelling of what you knew from, like, playing Ninja Gaiden on, like, the NES. It's just that. And then giving you more content and stuff. It's just the same exact thing as here, except it's, like, on the thought of, like, the Chrono Trigger type thing, you know? Where Chrono Trigger is in everybody's hearts is, like, how cool, like, all the characters are and how all those super moves are and, like, how good, like, you can get through the whole game. And it's very simple storytelling and the artwork. You get that exact same feeling here. Like, I feel like if I was to go through Chrono Trigger and then go through this, it's, like pretty much almost an identical type of thing, but in a good way, you know? Like, people just love that type of gameplay style and they love what they had with the storytelling and all that. And of course, obviously, with the artwork. And in this game, I feel like it's all that, plus the extra with the music, plus, like, the extra with, like, full-on side content. And I feel like you get that with Chrono Trigger 2, but, like, to another degree with this. Because you get a lot of side quests, way more than I thought, that really goes towards the ending of the game. Where in Chrono Trigger, you could, like, kind of bypass it all or whatever. But I wonder if you could actually do that on a new game run. On this, I'm not really sure how that would actually be handled, but either way, no, this game is fantastic. Still, like, probably, like, a pretty easy experience, all things considered, but it is, like, tricky of how, like, you want to, like, go through each battle, because, like, there's the system where, like, you have to hit them with certain things and you may not have it, or you have to take the hit on this one and then go for it later. Like, it's a very nice, good balance to keep you, like, intrigued on what you're doing on every turn and to make sure that you're doing it right on how you want to get through it. It's a great way to, like, make you engaged in every fight. Music, like I said, is fantastic. Sprite work is fantastic. I'm really happy that this game came out, like, right around my birthday, because it's, like, that felt like a good, like, thing to watch, like, as it was being made. And, like, every little thing I saw from it, I just wanted to see more, and I just wanted to play it. And I'm really glad I got a chance to actually beat it. It took a little bit because of, like, some other things going on in life, and also with the side content with the other streams, with Spider-Man and all the things, like, kind of just having a little more priority to finish it for, like, before this. But all things considered, I took about 30 hours. You definitely could beat it in a much shorter time. I just took longer with it because, I don't know, like, there was just, like, some things I got stuck on or whatever. But you definitely could have gone through this without having to do so much exploration like I did. But I did it, like, as I was doing the game regular, because that's just how I kind of play it. And, yeah, we're just going to get through the end and get through that true ending. And I don't think that the score is really going to change for me. After I do the true stuff, you know, I feel like it's going to be relatively the same. If I were to put a number on it, I'm thinking a 9.5 is very fair. I do not think it's my favorite game of the year. I will think about it later of what that is. It might be top 5 of what I played this year for sure. I think top 5 is very good. Maybe top 3. I have to look at everything else again. But, yeah, even with that, like, this was such a stacked year, and this being an indie type of thing, you know, and for it to have as much love and care for it and still be better than some of the other games that came out this year for me, it's a very, very strong showing of what you can make of just a lot of time and effort that goes into something that's special like this, you know? And I really just hope, I know that there's DLC coming for this game, so I will be streaming that when that does drop, but maybe I might do, like, another thing to, like, say, oh, the DLC is separate from the game, or if it's a combined thing, like, kind of how RE4 is, like, with the Ada Wong DLC. So, I wonder how it's going to play into it. I wonder if it's going to be, like, a DLC where it's, like, combined, or, like, more like a separate story. I don't really know. I guess we'll find out when we get the true ending, but hopefully we get some good surprises when that does eventually drop, which will probably be next year or something. So, I'll definitely keep an eye out for it. And I will stream it, like I said. But like I said, a 9.5, I feel like, is a very good score. Probably in the S or the double S is here. Because there's not much more I really wanted from this game. I feel like I kind of got everything that I wanted. It's just... Garl sucks. So, I hate this fucking guy. I hate him so much. He definitely brings the entire experience down. So he docks the game 5 points. Or 0.5 points. Just for being around and being involved in the game. So... Garl really makes your entire experience worse if you play this game. So just keep that in mind when you play it your own. Nah, I'm just joking. A lot of people like Garl. I just do not like him because he's such a fucking weirdo. Do not like Garl. Hate that fucker. Yeah, there's nothing really much else. Character-wise, yeah, aside from Garl. Valor and Zale are great. You know, they're really good protagonists. I'm glad I went with Valor at the beginning because I really like her moveset more than Zale. Obviously, it doesn't really change the story of who you actually make as, like, the primary leader. But I do like Valor's design more. I love the blue hair aesthetic and, like, the cape and all that. She just looks better as a character, like, as the main character than Zale, in my opinion. What's his name? Best is great. I love Best a lot. Best is awesome. I love his little knickknacks of, like, him turning into a bottle, turning into a little wheel. He's just, aesthetically, he's great. I love that dude. Best is awesome. Rashaan is a bitch, and I guess we'll see, like, how the DLC and, like, the extra content from here. Just bitch made at the end. It was really interesting, like, as the architect or the archaeologist, like, speaking about the story. And I liked how, like, where it was going. And the build-up for the story between him and the Fleshmancer, I really like the fact that it's, like, a dynamic, like, they were actually friends and they, like, were on multiple universes. The storytelling of, like, how they have, like, the multiple Sea of Stars and, like, the Sea of Universes, I love how they made that work. And the fact that, like, it was, like, brought up like that, you can kind of get little hints of it, like, as you kind of go along, because you get a storyteller in there, you're like, how is he telling the entire story and all that stuff, right? And you kind of get a little bit more as you get through it, and like those other like storytelling bits you get with Teeks, it all builds to like how well it was written and how well it came together. So I do feel like overall it was well written and well explained of what the story really is about. So definitely like that. But then he became bitch like later on, then fucked off and then just said, hi, I'm here, you can kill this guy, and then leaves. Don't know what that's about, but still cool at the halfway mark. Then he slowly became worse. But Sarai is queen. Sarai is the best, so, hands down. You think that any other character is better than Sarai, you are actually playing yourself, because Sarai is incredible. From the moment you see her being a mystery and all that stuff, from her helping you out, saving Garl's life, unfortunately, and her moveset, how well she could just teleport using the daggers, like all that stuff. And her being the captain of the pirates, then fucking going to her own world because she wanted to like make sure that you were good enough to help her land and her people. Sarai's great. Sarai is like the best character, like hands down. Nothing else to say about that. She's cool. I don't think there's much else to talk about. I already talked about the combat, talked about the artwork, talked about the music, story. Just big shout outs to Sabotage. Like, that's two in a row that they slam dunk and fucking home run derby, just constantly hitting it out of the park. These guys are I really wonder what their next project would be after this. Like, once the DLC's done, I'm really interested to see what else they would want to tackle, because they went from, you know, side-scrolling action game, like, very responsive and, you know, being attentive to, like, your environments and platforming, to JRPG with other elements on top of that, you know, with full-on exploration and everything. Both, the fact that they do two different genres, one right after the other, is incredible for, like, an indie studio for me. And the fact that they're both great, and the music's great, everything, it's fantastic. And I love the callbacks to the music when it comes to the messenger and the actual areas to it. I just fell in love with that. It's wonderful. Yeah, I don't think there's really much else to say. 9.5, S class, maybe double S class. We'll see how it stacks up with everything else I've played at the end of the year, but definitely a slam dunk if you have not played this yourself. And even though if you may have seen it, I appreciate you guys watching, but buy this and play this yourself. This is just a great game. Play it. So good. All right. Let's ultra speed, ultra hode. Let's get to the true ending, shall we? Oh, that's right. He did say to like go over to him and see what happens. Super backers. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm not involved because I don't think I backed this game while it was in Kickstarter. Yeah, unfortunately, I was not involved. I would have really liked to have been involved in it. This is just an incredible game. I'm really glad that there was like so much support from it. So damn good. So that's like five slam dunks from like Kickstarters and all that stuff. Pretty much starting off with like Shovel Knight and shit. Oh shit, there's even more backers. Way more, holy moly. I know it's like you probably spend enough money and then you get your name on here. It's probably like different tiers of like how they made that work. Boo! I'm glad you're dead. Fuck Garl. And thank you for playing. Heart, heart, heart. Very great game. And so we gather each year as they fly by our world, and on their never-ending watch, and together we remember their story. Hi, Sage. Oh, wow. That's a long-ass time. Is it true they always fly on the warrior cook's birthday? No one knows for sure. Sounds rather poetic, though, doesn't it? Now run along, everyone. I must check in on the crypt's renovations. Thank you for the story, High Sage. I like old teaks better. I like old teaks. How's the progress? Pretty good. I've been thinking about Yomara's notes. You know, about the flood. No worries. I'll make the big window extra thick. Extra thick. Well, do you like the central piece? Yes, it's perfect. So where does it pick up then? What if we just load in or we actually get to play them? A mysterious device has appeared in the moorlands. You can now save and return right before the final boss to complete side content. The mysterious device might also be worth investigating. Yeah, well. Alright, all we have to do now is just go to the magic conch shell. And then, yeah. I think there's like one other thing we have to do. I'll take a look at that once we get there. Maybe it's like another side boss that we missed or something. Alright, so zoom in. So where is that again? Is that the Watcher Island? Oh, I did that right. That's the back entrance. Right. Yeah. I think we better to come in from the back here, and then we go down that thing. Yeah. Right. While that's happening, I will take a quick look over at what we do for the end of the game. Well, actually, it's right here, so. Oh, you. There you go. Last time was my most precious one. No idea what it's for. The Rainbow Star flew up and disappeared. That's that. So there's one more, huh? Alright, what do we do for that? Sea of Stars. Unlock. True ending. 7 different side quests. So we did 6 of them. Then they need the 5 Solstice Shrines. We did that. Elder meets boss. Then the Gun Goddess. The 3 Sunken Ruins. Defeat the Sea Slug boss. Go to the Dweller's Fall area at the Port Brisk where players join Bisk for the party. After that, they will... Oh, there's Colosseum challenges in Brisk. So... Go to the Dweller's Fall arena in the port town of Brisk where players must join the Bisk app to the party. I don't think that's really red while. Okay, so we did that. I was gonna read this one. Help and find four more inhabitants. Yeah, we did that. All that. Unlock the sealed Dokari ruins. Yep. Help free the Duke Avery. Yep. Help Bis become champion of the Dweller Arena in Brisk. Okay, so I guess that's what it is. Okay. So we gotta go to Brisk. We'll see how we actually tag that along. Yeah, we just go back up then. Yeah. Man, I gotta go through, like, the entire soundtrack again and see, like, which one's my personal favorite, because it has so many good ones that, like, thinking about it, like, right now, I can't really put a pin on which one I like the most. Brisk is, Sleeper Island, yeah. There is another, like, little secret, to do, like, the extra stuff, like, with the hammer or something, like, that I'm not gonna do. Like, that I'm good with. Okay, let's see. So I'm not particularly sure where to find him or anything. I just gotta kind of take a quick look. If not, I'll just see if I can find like a little video or something. Try to see where to go. Yeah, let's see. Dweller Arena. Let me just find that. How to unlock the Dweller's Fall Arena. Arena will automatically unlock any time after you recruited Bis to your party. He tells you the arena and the camp. You go to the newly renovated port city of Brisk and go up the stairs where there are only two merchants in town. If you go around the fountain above the stars, or the stairs, and enter the house with the red carpet, you'll find the arena. Okay, so it's up north. Okay, let me see. You get back up here. Okay. So it's actually over here. I don't remember him saying anything about an arena in here. I don't remember that. It was like one of like the side things he talked about or something. Don't really need anything. Apparently there's like a room with like a past the fountain it said. Here we go. Don't remember this, yeah. Let's see. Welcome to Dweller's Fall Arena. On these sands, the mighty gather and mightier prevail, and the mightiest become legend. Hi there. Would it be possible for my friends and I to enter the tournament? New challengers? Certainly, but we do have a rule limiting new entrants to a maximum of 2 sidekicks. Also, the use of items is forbidden. Got it. Thank you. This place is everything I was hoping for. Can we give it a try now? Okay, so... sure. Bronze, silver, and gold. Okay. So I could take 2 of my friends with me. The Grey Alchemist puppet could be amusing. Who else could join? I'll do it. Perfect. Let's go. Okay, so me or Valor. Okay, so this. Oh, we actually. Hey, we control the homie. Let's go. Sick. Oh, what the hell? We got Catman. Sig? Okay, cool. Good day, people of Brisk and beyond. Welcome, all, to Dweller's Fall Arena. Today is a very special day, for our new challenger is accompanied by the mighty Lunar Monk, who saved our town from total destruction on that fateful day. No way! I heard she can breathe underwater. Huzzah! Is she from Dokari Village? Now, please welcome Best in living, the Living Glass Golem and his companions. Woohoo! Best! Can they clear the bronze rank? We shall see. For their first fight, Please welcome the renowned and unforgiving, the admirable, Clawless Crab Crew. Yay! Oh my god, they're so cute. They're my favorite. Now, let the fight begin. Legu. Well, we don't have any sun, so that's peculiar. Oh, they do no damage, bro. Like, it is sad. Actually, no. We'll make you do that. At least just to stop that. At least a little bit. Almost killed it, too. Ah, you healed? Nah, not by much, though. That's fine. Alright, get one of them out. Unbelievable! The Clawless Crab Crew bites the dust in record time. Best, best, best! And now, directly from the Moorlands, I present to you the Bomb Bouncing Brothers! Look at- oh, so this is just like, you fight every, like, you fight, like, everything. Cool. So yeah, we'll stop you. Yeah. Stop that. Wasn't really sure who was trying to hit, actually. Body. You don't get any experience from this though, so. Best will climb the ranks in no time. Yes, sir. The Ghoul Goof Group. Alright, cool. My friend can strike that pose. Alright. Kind of have to let this go, yeah. Not much I can really do about that. Nice. Exactly what I was looking for. Oh, I forgot that does heal him, yeah. Yeah, this is definitely not anything to, like, think about. It's pretty easy. That's it for the bronze. Nice. Okay. Alright. So that was, what, 3 fights? It's not too bad. Zale and Sarai? Let's go. I'm not too fond of this type of entertainment, but if it matters to you, I'm in. Yeah, cool. I like how we're getting everybody to like get a shot at it. The two blades, too. Okay. Hopefully we don't get hoed by like the Luna or anything. You expect another great performance. So this is accompanied by the Solar Blade Dancer who helped us from that cataclysm. The Prickly Pirate Party. Oh, cool. I actually forgot about these enemies, too. Hey, you can just leave it. Well, that goes to show I really should not be worried about this. Wait, that time we got experience. Huh. Okay. Fancy Fencing Force. Oh, right. These dudes. Yeah. Oh, cool. Cool. Yeah, I forgot about them, too. Dodge that real quick. Once again, not really worried about the damage. Like, they're really not that bad. Ooh. And that should kill him, yeah. Nice. Cool. Yeah. Well, missed all three of them. Let me get the dog. He had to go outside for a second. Hold on. I don't know where this other one went. Okay. Oh, whoops. Hold on. Ugh. There you go. Oy. The Watchmaker. It'll activate the moment it touches the sand. Are you ready? I can't hear you. Are you ready? Woo! Woo woo! The Watchmaker's is entry into the tournament. The defender, her title is a silver champion. Yoink. That was somehow a good throw. The Clockwork Abomination. Oh, cool. This is definitely a fight now. Okay, here we go. So yeah, we can just do this. That was pretty okay. that's really annoying. Time for friends. Oh, it just summons. Okay, that's not bad then. Never mind. Time for mayhem. Again, not really that bad. I thought that was gonna kill for sure. Time to fucking lay the sun in this fucking battle arena. This thing has a lot of health. Mayhem? Yeah. Does it do anything else aside from, like, shoot those things? Yeah, no, not quite. I don't think I did this one before. Oh, right, yeah, this one. Super cool. Finally, damn. That should have way more health than I thought it would. No experience either. We only got experience like once. Alright. Gold rank. Alright, who do we actually have for this one? Sapphire ingot. We made it to the gold rank. This is the last one. Valor and Zale, I would like you two to by my side for this one. Of course. You got it, Bess. Let's go then. Legu. Now we're gonna get like the dream team. Oh, whoops. Good day, people of Brisk, and welcome. Welcome all to the Dweller's Fall Arena. Here we are, the gold rank. Let's go, best. And it's my birthday. Hey, it's your birthday? Good shit. To calculate the event from the scalding depths of Kill Mountain and unknown lands above, I give you Big Buddy and Bad Bunnies. Wow. Oh, I'm so ready. Now, let the fight begin. Thank you. Alright, what do we got? Annoying already. Nice.
Pebble Arc. Higher damage to that. You know what? Then you can attack. Yeah. How do you spell his name? The green dude? You mean the one with the daggers? The green woman? That's, Sarai. S-E-R-A-I. Oh, they resist, yeah. That's alright, though. The one I didn't like? Oh, he wasn't green. He was like wearing brown or like beige. But his name's Garl. G-A-R-L. Please welcome the basic basement batch. Basic basement bitch. I feel like that's where it was going. Alright, cool. Alright, I definitely hate the wizards. We're just gonna have to, with that first. The one I like, that's the wait, the one I like, that's green? What? The green dude that I like? There's a green guy that I like? Oh, you know what? Regular attacking him, yeah. Well, tell me his name, now that you said it, Now I really have no idea what you're talking about. Now that you said it. What the hell? Oh. That was weird. Oh, he's pink! Oh my lord. Not like this. Not like this. Oh, actually, that hits all of them. Wow, that's cool. Single target. Single target. Yeah, we'll just try to just go for damage. Why not? Oh no, it's just best to like attack him here, yeah. That makes sense, being a mage, yeah. Only like suck with physicals. Gold Rake Finals. The time has come for Best to face not only the gold champion, but the gold standard of champions. The one with unparalleled pecs, unparalleled skill, and unparalleled charisma.
Can our rising star defeat the undefeated one? We are about to find out. Join us now, Champion of Champions. Let the crowd speak your name. Sligan or Silgane? Silgane? What the? Oh, I thought it was him, like, with the cannon. What the fuck? Wow. Okay, Hercule. Wow. I like this guy. Yeah. Sick. It feels like he would fit in Ultimate Muscle. Yeah. He would fit in that shit for sure. Yeah, not like it matters. Oh, ooh. Super Sclout. Oh my god, look at this guy. Oh, I like him. He's awesome. Look at this dude. We definitely needed him for the final battle. The fact that you could just have that on repeat. What the? Slapper something, what'd you say? Yeah. Dude, this is like the coolest guy. Damn, the double shit would've worked here. I can't get over him. He's like the fucking coolest. You know what? Yeah, we'll pass, actually. We'll save those. Ah, yeah, see? Wait. Fuck. Ah, damn it. That's alright. Yeah, got him. Outstanding, they've done it. Silgane has been defeated. Let's go. I still like Silgane better, wow. The time has come for our young group to face the ultimate challenge. Do they have what it takes? We shall see next time. This concludes today's event. Okay, so there's one more little bit after this. Special rank. Reaper's Mercy. What is that about? When health is above 50%, killing blows leave the target at 1% HP instead. Oh, so if you have half health, it's like second chance. You'll at least
Yeah, okay. That's actually pretty nice. There's no party limit for this one. Okay, cool. Now we get everybody. Is it just one fight, or is it like a series of fights? Because it said one challenge. I'm calling in sick tomorrow. The time has come to summon the ultimate challenge. Is everyone ready for the real show? Alright. Then let us call upon it. The Terror of the Seas. The Devourer of Sunken Ships. Crystallion? 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 Alright. Was it like fucking red rum? Oh, that's a crab. That's a crab man. That's really cool looking, though. Well, that's interesting. I don't want to see what the thing for that is. Ooh, okay, alright, the fucking music too, shit. Alright, so first, that. Oh, it just resets. Ooh, okay. What do we do? This is actually interesting to think about. I think just stopping one, at least. Then I could do power smash to this. Yeah. Okay. At least it stops one of them. Condo throwdown. Okay, that's not all that bad damage. Oh, so they actually do spells and stuff. Okay, that's pretty cool. So it's a strike. And heals too. It healed that one. It didn't actually heal the other one. And they don't have health bars either. Yeah, just stop whatever he's doing. Yeah, that's fine with whatever this is. Red rum raisin? Ugh. Oh, it's all random. Oh, cool. Okay. Something to think about then. Excuse me. You know what I was thinking about the other day, babe, actually? I kind of want to have that ice cream again. The one we went to. Your place. I really want to get that again, actually.
I'd healed him. Shit. Okay, well. It is what it is. I really want to try some of those other flavors. No, but the peach pie! That's out of context as fuck, isn't it? Oh, man. I really want to get that peach pie. Healed that. Who cares? Fine with that. Well, it's up to you. You may as well like do like a coin flip. You may as well like just do that. It really doesn't matter to me if we do one or the other. We really gotta try that peach pie though. No pressure. Nice that we stopped that. That's tough. Didn't get much out of that. Well, that's fucking mean. I can't really do anything about this, so I may as well just stop one. I fucked up, by the way. Yeah, I totally fucked up. I meant to switch, but I didn't do it. Trade? Now, that's a lot of health. Shit. And he heals. Ah! Motherfucker. How do we get past this? Oh, we don't have the combo up. Lunar Shield. I'll be outside, Crumble, like the hash-slinging slasher. Oh, man, like, give me my peach cobbler. Goddamn. Swap out for you. That's fine with me. Oh, we killed one. Oh, okay. Well, that's good. The fact that we can kill it. I should know that we could. That's fine, yeah. Swap to you. Moonerang that shit. Yeah, let's go. Hey, what's up, Motion? You did miss the regular ending. Pretty good damage there. Best bet is to swap for you. Actually, swap for you and then do that, yeah. What'd you think? Very easy boss. Holy shit. You just stop all of her attacks. I don't even think I saw her like ultimate attack once. Oh my god, that shit was free. But that also might be because, like, I might be a little over-level with my gear and stuff. But at the same time, I just, like, every combo I got, just delay her attack even further. And delay it. And it just never came out. So, I feel like that was, like, the best way for me to, like, kind of go about that. That shit was pretty easy. Aside from that, though, it was really good. Boss-wise, specifically, yeah. We're gonna build up the combo again, yeah. It's fine. Destoria and Rashan ultimate stun locks everyone. It's ridiculous. It's so good. I realized, like, why let them fight? I'm just gonna Dante Infinite them all day. Like, fuck it. It's so easy. Like this. Go fuck yourself. Like, why fight this, right? You know what I mean? Like, fuck that. Oh, I fucked up. Whoops. I looked at the chat for a second. That's my fault. Well, I wonder what I'm gonna be doing. Oh, I could have done the double thing. Well, whatever. Yeah, I just realized that. Whoops. Best bet is to... Yeah, fuck it. I'm already gonna get that anyway. Who cares? Yeah, here we go. Combined with a nano injector for faster combos is pretty free. Yeah, for real, right? Yeah, really, honestly, the game's really not that hard once you, like, really figure out the mechanics and everything. As long as you don't skip a beat or anything, like, you may take, like, a few hits here and there, but overall, really not that bad. Oh my god, it's so sad. Actually, I don't think I'll be able to hit it this time. Yeah, I'm actually gonna miss it. Do you have a combo that does... No, yeah, wow. Not able to do it this time. Hey, look at me go. Well, I get to see what the attack is this time, at least. If that killed him, that would have been so funny. Oh, right, the throwdown, yeah. Yeah, it's fucking nothing. Let's go. Good shit. Oh, he's a little baby crab. Oh, look at him. Look at a little cutie. Folks, it's finally happened. Best and his group have defeated the master of the arena and broken the charm. Look at its size. Kraus Stalian is finally free. Best. Yeah. Ooh. We did it. Legu. Congratulations, Best. How do you feel? Amazing. Such a cutie. Why is Crystallion so tiny now? Oh, you have something for me? Vitrix Simulacrium? He likes you. Aww. The champions became friends. Talk about a heartwarming finale. Crystallion has decided to move in with Best. The Vespertine just got a cutter. What the hell? What? A cutter? What do you mean? What does that mean? I want to see what that means. What the fuck does that mean? All right, well, we're going straight there, so. What? I don't, cut what? Oh, cuter. Oh, I thought it meant like to cut shit because it's got like things or whatever. Okay. Well, now I have to see it. Like, I don't know if you can actually go on to the Vespertine though. Yeah, I don't think you can, but whatever. That's cool. Oh, also, what is the Settles Living Glass in Perfect Harmony? Nice. So now we have everybody's So the side stuff in this game really just gets you the best equipment for everybody. So it all kind of leads up to have them all like just get it all. So that's pretty cool. I have like in the regular thing, but. Oh, B, enter boat. Oh, yeah, no, I never did that. Yeah, I don't know you could do that. Hey, look at that. Okay, so you just talked to you to set sail. Huh? Rashawn's puppet points at something on the map. Great alchemist, you're trying to tell us something? Perhaps we should investigate the location. Wonder what that's supposed to be about then. Yeah, I had no idea you could do that. Yeah, I never looked. Aw, hey. Crystallion is having the time of his life. Look at him go. Aw, that's super cute. Hell yeah, dude. Well, it's a good thing I'm doing this now so we can actually see what's going on. Of course. Champions. Gross. Oh. Oh, is this your, Oh, I've only died once. Hey. And this is like to keep track of, find every single treasure. That's an achievement. Cook every recipe at least once. And some other hidden achievements and stuff. Okay, well, that's pretty cool. Do we actually have a story to give you? No. Alright, well, that's it. Okay. Yeah, let's go and see what that trending is. I'm not going to personally do all those champion things. I say fuck that. I'm really not interested in that. I really don't want to spend that time off stream just to see the other extra little bit. We're just gonna go here and do whatever this is. Where is that? That's in here, right? Yeah, I think that's this way. To the moorlands and to the top. Which actually, I think the best way to go is the other way, I think. Yeah, I think we have to go like from here, I think is the closest bet. Yeah, because then you go back across that other way. Yeah. I remember. So I'm just gonna look up whatever that little secret is, like with those squishy hammers, or like the fees hammers, whatever they're called. I'm just gonna go take a look at that on like YouTube or something. We'll see it here on stream. I'm just not gonna go do that. I really don't want to. I've done enough for like the true ending of the game. That's good enough for me, you know? It's really? I really don't want to do the champions things. I really don't want to. Really? Son of a bitch. Really? It's like that? God damn it. I really don't want to do those side things. The fucking champions things. That seems like it's such a slog. Like, I really don't want to do that. It's definitely worth it. I guess we'll watch it. Like, let me ask you a question. How could that be worth doing those things? Like, I personally feel just fine just doing it. You know what I mean? Like, just watching it. Am I going the right way? Is it this way? It's been so long since I've been to this section. Oh, here we go. Yeah, it's right here. Seems we have everything now. You will definitely appreciate it. I'm not gonna regret it. I'll tell you this much. I won't regret just watching it. Dare I say I missed out on the bigger picture? But like, is it really worth just like do? All right, we'll just do this first. We'll do this first. You know about this thing? Yes, the great alchemist told me about the chronophage. While he was working on my living glass form. Rashan left us something? The chronophage is his parting gift to you. It was enchanted to activate in response to your initial deeds as up-and-coming guardian gods. A gift? That is how he described it. I got the sense that he wished to take responsibility for something. It should take us somewhere. All I know is how to open it, and that only Valor and Zale and I can go. Are you sure this is safe? Yes, the great alchemist could have stopped you at any time if that had been his wish. How do we open this gift? You must provide the memento of a happy memory. What does that mean? He said you would know. Cookie jar. Oh, that's what the cookie... What? The fucking cookie jars was in my key inventory the whole time? We should go now while it's active. Be safe out there. I'll be here when you return. Cool. Okay. For me, not until I dig some digging after. Sounds like you're saying badge, yeah. They're beautiful. What do you call them? Time shards. You always were the better artist. Yeah, we get to see Grog get fucked. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. 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 Oh no. Are you fucking kidding me? I want to go back. Oh, what the fuck? No. No, no, no. No, no, no. No, no, no. You've gotta be kidding me. You've gotta be fucking kidding me. No way. I thought that motherfucker was dead. Fuck. Are you serious? This is the worst game. This is the worst fucking game I've played.
This is the worst game. This is the worst game. No! And you... No! Are you fucking serious? Are you fucking serious? I'm gonna lose best, actual best boy for fucking girls bitch ass? I'm so upset. I'm so upset. I am so upset. I am so infuriated right now. There's no way they're gonna kill Best and give me Garl instead. This is fucking bullshit. This is dumb. This is the worst. I'm so sad. I'm so angry. Beast? Oh, Beast. Oh, okay. Best Beast. Okay. He's the best Beast. Well, yeah, that makes more sense, doesn't it? Yeah. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. He's gonna fucking die. You must act now before the diversion is over. Yoink. What? What? What happened? Is she holding him? Just don't leave me buried under the tree for too long. Wow. Beast is actually the fucking coolest. Beast is so sick. Beast is actually the fucking coolest. Beast is great. Oh, that's how that works. Oh, so he like be... Oh, wow. That's how that works. Oh. Wow. But he's supposed to die anyway, right? Oh, no, no, no. This is before that. Oh, man. Oh, I deleted this, that's right, yeah. How are you, what do you mean by you were watching us? Hate Garl. So Beast is Jesus Christ. I'm not allowed to talk about what I saw on the other side, but when I came back, they said they would grant me one wish. Sure did, but it can wait. I want to be the one cooking for tonight. My wish demands a bit of an errand, though. We don't have to go for it if we don't have time. I'll tell you at camp later if you want. Okay, so he's got another side shit? Reunited with the best friend, Valor and Zaylor fucked off, and the game is the worst. I'm actually super upset. Thank God Beast didn't die. I would have been, like, the actual, like, pissed off most guy. I would have broken something. Maybe my pen.
Okay, can I move? Yeah. All right. What's your side mission? What a time, huh? I sure didn't have resurrection on my list when we started our adventure. One more fatigue storybook, I guess. Seriously, though, it did get kind of scary. Thanks for pulling me out of there. I know activating the chronophage or whatever took a lot of effort. We'd have done it faster if we knew. And come on, you'd do the same for us. In a heartbeat. Oh, right, there's one thing I wanted to share. So I'm not allowed to talk about what I saw on the other side, but when it became clear that I would return, I was allowed to make a single wish. What'd you ask for? Dinner with all my friends at the Golden Pelican. Sure did. I'm going to host my own reverse funeral. And I hate him so much. I like this guy. Well, that's nice. Thing is, though, I'm not too sure how that works. All I was given is this fishing hook. Hook of time. I'm sure we'll figure it out. There's an island that I feel connected to the magic fish hook I was given, right here. Oh, that's the Seller's Island. Yeah, okay. And it kept telling me, like, you had to progress even further. Yeah, okay, alright. And there is, like, a door, like, yeah. Everyone ain't slept together that night, and they fucked all night, because they're bitches. God, I hate you. I hate you so much. I hate this guy. Fucking goddamn it. How do I go back, like, faster? I think we go up and then we go down. That's probably the fastest way. Or up? I really don't remember. Think down. Yeah, I think down. Main character without being the main character. I hate this fucking guy. I want all of his pets to die in front of him. And I want him to be the one that runs him over. I'm really upset, actually. Like, I'm unironically upset that he's still around. What the fuck? So that's the whole party? Yeah, I guess cargo is, like, completely removed. So, yeah, cool, at least you get a six-party team, you know? Like, you actually get every character at some point. But you actually, like, go out of your way to do it. So, that's neat that you can do that. What's not neat is that it's Garl, so... I'm upset. Oh, this place. Right. Yeah. Oh, there's a little sparkly thing up there, actually. What the fuck? Oh, cool. That looks cool. I had to actually run to the bathroom, so you know what? I'm going to take a quick save. I'm going to piss out my hopes and dreams that the fact that Garl was dead, and I'd never have to see him again. I'll be right back. Really need to let out my anger.
You.
Welcome back to hell. Alright, let's see what we got. Garl is here. He's got a fucking magic pan. Oh! Alright, well, I am interested to see his ultimate attack, at least. So, we'll get to that, I guess, at some point. I legit think that we can only really get that, like, in a boss, because I don't really think you can really get an ultimate attack in, like, a regular fucking fight. So, hopefully we can get it in, like, one of the, upcoming areas. Fishing dungeon key. Oh, hey! Garl hurls an enemy for best to power smash. I mean, yeah, I guess we may as well see, like, what the combos are for him, too. Oh, it's an alley-oop type of thing. Oh, okay. That wasn't that bad. Area damage, that's right. Hurls, the ultimate. So we had picks a random item, area damage. Oh, yeah, so... Right. He doesn't have a three-piece, so... Okay. Blunt damage to one. Okay, I honestly did not remember most of his fucking skill set. I'm really not happy. I'm sorry. I am not happy. His ultimate's pretty cool. Well, it's something to look forward to, I guess. The glowing one is the key. All you have to do is catch it. Wow. Aw, you bitch. Alright, well, he is not biting. That was, like, right in his face, too. Wow. Fucking sacrificing. Maybe it's, like, one of those, like, I get everything, then he'll want to get me? I don't know. Oh, no, I think I have to, like, jump in it and catch it like that. Maybe that's what it's telling me. Because I see, like, little areas to jump off from. Yeah, alright, maybe that's what it is. It does like to hover in a little, couple other spots. What is this? There's a fish-shaped keyhole behind the statue. Okay, well, that's where we're getting from. Come on, bitch. Cool. I thought you had to, like, jump, like, it wouldn't bite. You had to, like, jump in the water, like, when it was under you or something. Oh, very, very easier than I thought it would be. The only thing about Garl's moveset that I like is the fact that he has Nourish. Nourish is actually a really good healing tool. They also give, like, no experience here either. Pretty weak, but... let's check around before I go up there. And actually take a look at the environment. Is there anything down here? Nope, okay. Man, I'm sorry, I'm just not happy. The fact that he's fucking still alive. This bitch. Hold on a second. What the hell's that? Yeet. Whoa, big mama. Oh, you're cool. Hoi. Well, well, well. Look what we've got on... What you've gone and done. Hey, mister. Sorry, it's just... I was given this... Easy now, son. I'm leading this conversation. Bitch, we caught you. If there's one thing I know for sure, it's that you need the hook of time to get in here. And if there's another thing I know for sure... It's that they don't just up and give the hook of time to anyone. I just asked, really. Right. Look, I get it. I also got a return. But point is, they must have liked you a lot. Oh, I don't know about that. The oblivious type, huh? Fine, I'll bite. What exactly did you ask for? I just wanted dinner with my friend at the Golden Pelican in Brisk. Oh yeah? Now that does change everything, doesn't it? Do you know about the place? Know about it? I built it myself. Really? Chef Bass, or Chef Bass, wow, at your service. No way! You're the chef? This dude fucking loves Gordon Ramsay. In the flesh. So, can we have the dinner? Be quite the disappointment if I said no at this point, huh? Yeah, so tell him. Tell him no, fuck him. Fuck Garl. You and your friends are officially invited. How many will be attending? How many can we be? It's your wish, son. You tell me. This is too much. Okay, let's see. Definitely all of us here. Plus Malcolmon, Teeks, and the pirates. Oh, I bet Moraine would show up too. There would be 12 of us, if that's okay. Good on you for making count. Right on. How does it work? Do we just show up at the Pelican, or the Golden Pelican? That you do. And then you give this to Gasper. Gilded invitation. This is exciting. Thanks, Chef Bass. Or Bass, I keep saying that. You got it. Is there anything else at the top? There is. Yeah. Ooh. Oh, that's what that is that whole time. Oh, wow. Okay. All right. Back to Brisk. That's over this way. And that's, like, all the way at the top. Oh, I think this way? Yeah, here we go, here we go. Yeah, this is the guy that's like, get the fuck out of here if you're running this shit, yeah. Oh, a private invitation from our chef. You'll need proper attire for this special occasion. Please gather the other guests. Our tailors will be right with you. Oh, cool. Do we get, like, new outfits and shit? Oh, that'd be sick. And a bow tie, please. Oh, you would fucking... Such a bitch. You fucking got a bow tie? I don't know. I think it'll look great on you. Zale looks like a cowboy. Please sit still, Mr. Malcolm. We are almost finished. Hey! Damn! Everybody looks good. Everybody got a fucking up. Except Garl, because he's alive. Oh my god, I love little top hat. Oh, he's so cute. Look at him. Zale looks great. Wait, where's Oh! Yo, Valor? Yo, Valor? Chill out. Wow, and the scarf is like the little thing to- Wow, dude. Serve him up, Gasper. Of course, chef, right away. Bitch, what are we making? What do we got? Yeah, oh wow, they put fucking Garl in the middle because they think he's Jesus Christ. Enjoy my last supper. Yeah, fucking die, Garl. Just don't get resurrected again. This is fucking innuendo, isn't it? Should there be anything else you need, just let me know. Yeah, fucking Garl. The headmaster's there. Even the little fucking squid dude has a little getup too. You gotta do the honors, pal. Oh, I don't know. This is about all of us. I think we should just dig in. Elder Moraine, was it? As I am sure you understand, tradition demands that. Of course. Attention, please. We're gathered here today to mark the return of someone truly special. Okay. Thank God we skipped that bit. And then they let me keep the fort. Well, that sure was nice of them. And you repaid this kindness a thousandfold. As a bit of an elemental mage myself, I must say your work there was quite the impressive feat. I only did it for Garl. You shut up. Yeah, you all did so much for me. A lot more than I could ask for. Valor is fucking gorgeous, bro. She got that fit. God damn, that shit is S-class. Zale looks pretty cool, too. I like the slick back. I don't think we got a good look at Sarai, though. Yeah, oh, this still doesn't look that great. The outfit in general looks better as the sprites than the still. To Garl. Why would he say that? I hate him so much. I can't believe how lucky I am to have all of you. I guess the final battle awaits. We can worry about that tomorrow. Let's just make the best of this moment. Gasper? Is it too late now for me to make a toast? Whatever you fancy, this is your moment. Great. What? Wow! Link that, please. I definitely want to see that. Link that, please. She looks great, but I need to see that. Link that to me. Put it in a general or something. I'd love to see that. Let's see here. What do you have to say? Thank you, my dear friends, for joining me in celebration. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I am Jesus Christ. To Teeks for unwavering support and unquenchable thirst for knowledge. To Teeks! I think it's her and Teeks that don't get one. Yeah, Teeks, yeah. I was about to say. Teeks looks alright. Yeah, Teeks looks fine. To Malcolmud for teaching us that one can always turn their life around, no matter their age. To Malcolmud. To Yolande, Valtrade, and Kenathan for their spirit of adventure and for always keeping their eyes on the target, no matter how dire things get. To Yolande, Valtrade, and Kenathan. Kenathan's the best one. Free. Kenathan's great. To Moraine, for standing firm in the face of insurmountable grief and never wavering in his faith in my friends. To Moraine. To Sarai, for enduring the impossible and being the coolest person I know. To Sarai, yeah! To Rashaan and Beast, for saving my life. To Rashaan and Beast. Rashaan's the worst character because he allowed him to live. And finally, to Valor and Zale, for getting me out of Mooncradle and letting me travel the world to encounter countless wonders. But most importantly, for being the best friends anyone could ask for. To Valor and Zale. Man, Valor's fucking outfit. On this warm evening, the abundance of food and good times with his loved ones gave Garlet an epiphany. The ultimate meal. Legendary feast. And question pack 11. We don't actually have to do question pack 11. Motherfucker, you don't keep the outfits. My disappointment is immeasurable. And my day is ruined. I also have to eat something. Because I have max right now. Even better when you don't have to make it yourself. That's just... maybe get rid of that. Sure. Alright, so now we pretty much just go straight to the final boss. I know we could do question pack 11, but I think that's in relation to the other ending, which I really don't have to do now. So we'll just go and do the true ending, and then we'll find out what that little extra bit is at the end. While we do this, I'll take a quick look to see if I could find it. Sea of Stars... Flimsy Hammer ending? Yeah. Flimsy Hammer ending. Okay. Oh, whoops. If I didn't have to do all the conches or, whatever, if I didn't have to do that, I wouldn't really care, but I have to do that, and I really don't want to do all that. I spent enough time in this game. Party? Oh, that's just free. Yeah. I can pretty much make three of them. I'll just make one. Who cares? You don't have all 30? What do you mean? Or 60? What do you mean? Don't have all 60 conches? I did already. I got to, I dropped it off, and, the star went away. Yeah. I did that before I did all this. Conches, yeah. What I'm saying is, like, I meant to do, not the conches, but the game. The fucking game, whatever. I just really don't want to do those. Like, I don't know why I'm so hell-bent on not wanting to do it. Like, I tried it once and I didn't like it, and it's probably just because I didn't understand it. I just really don't want to have to do all of that, and that's going to take time on the stream. I'd rather just do this, and if it's just an ending, like, then I feel like I did enough. Like, getting the true ending is, like, more rewarding than, like, getting another additional thing, and I'd rather just watch that. And especially since that, like, ending thing, to do that is something I don't want to do. I'm fine with just watching it. I'm cool. Let me spell it out. Alright. He's gonna really try to win me over. I mean, I do have, 60 conscious is true ending. Yeah. I did that already. Yeah. I have a flimsy hammer, and apparently there's four of them. You get one for the question pack, which we can do. There's one for doing all the other games, and there's one other one to do. I kind of forgot what that one was when I did the read, so. Easter egg, yeah. Yeah, so it's the Easter egg, yeah. All right, so let's run it back. I don't know if I saved it. Congratulations, you have quite the nuisance. Prepare yourself. Blah, blah, blah. Same old, same old. Play by the rules. Decide the fate of your realm and all the worlds. Can you defeat my strongest lieutenant? Same old, same old. I call upon you, my champion. Hey, you coward. How about fighting your own battles for a change? This is the fucking dumbest person. All you do is corrupt everything you touch and make people suffer. I'm kicking you out. You would challenge a god? God? I told you once, you son of a creep. You're nothing but a loser. And so the fool repeats his mistake. There will be no time travel trick saving you this time. Come then. Eternal pain awaits. Oh, cool. Wow, like, no music either. Oh, I was about to say. Never mind. Moonerang. This track better be ridiculous. It's already popping off. Oh, that's a lot of damage. Well, that's not too bad, though. Oh, shit. I wonder what else I'm gonna be doing. Oh, whoops. You. The Stunlock begins. All right, let's swap. Let's see what Garl's ultimate is. Let's just see it. Sleeper's Fury. Oh, shit. Oh. I had no fucking... Wow, cool. I guess that totally makes sense.
Wow. Okay. All right. It literally has nothing to do with him, so I'm cool with it. Breaks all locks? Really? Oh, I thought it was literally just like one of each. Wow, dude. That's a pretty good ultimate attack, honestly. Yeah, in case you really don't want to get hit by something. Honestly, that's pretty dope. That is a nice addition to it, for sure. You know what? Go fuck yourself. We're gonna get my boy to fucking elbow drop your shit. Fuck yeah. Yeah. Whatever. I can't get out of this one. Maw. Sure. That really wasn't all that bad. Yeah. Yeah. Literally, why not? Fuck you. just delay this shit. What the hell? What? Whoa! Oh! Oh! Yes, 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 yes. More bullet hell. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, super cool. Fuck yeah, dude. I know you're gonna get more of it. Okay, so it has different sections, yeah. Get out of my way, fool. Plasma beam! God damn, that was 60%. Eat shit. Oh. Plasma beam! Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, okay. Gotcha. Yeah, that's really not that bad, all things considered. Man, what a fucking cool-ass fucking final boss, dude. Plasma beam! What a fucking sick, like, part of that. Multiple hittings. Well, I don't want to take it, so, Garl, do your stupid fucking dumb shit. Shut up. Get rid of it. It's a good thing I saved it, because I figured it's like, I'd rather just take whatever that hit is and not see whatever this is, you know? Yeah, this is easy. Oh, wait, first you, yeah. Moonerang, Moonerang, Moonerang. I'll heal her. Eat shit. Sure. Get the magic up a bit. And yeah. I'll throw Lunar Shield. Yeah, why not? Literally no reason. Yeah, I forgot the timing of that. Yeah. I fucked up. Moonerang, Moonerang, every time. We'll save it. Wow, still actually take the damage anyway. Wow. Guess what? Eat shit. May as well just do a full heal too at the same time. Oh, you know what? No. Ah, too late. Whatever. Ah, see, that's what I wanted to do. balls. Well. Probably still not a way to get through it, though. I'll try. I might be able to build up the combo and then get that one. Wow, look at that. I'm so sick. I'm actually kind of ridiculous at this game. Then we're gonna Sunarang. Well, again, when they fucking get stun locked, it's pretty easy. How is this possible? How? Better start believing. We're kicking you out. Oh, shit. I didn't think we were going straight into a fucking cutscene. What? Bro, you lost. Get the fuck out of here. He's really gone. We're free. Hope, it's been so long. Zale, I can feel it too. We have to go right now and face the World Eater. Will you return? We can feel everything now. There's just so much for us to do. So many worlds, I have no idea. There's a goodbye. Oh, stop being dramatic. Just promise you'll visit from time to time, okay? Of course. That's more like it. We'll see you soon, girl. First sweet. I know. You do Luana and Sol and stuff. Whenever you have to, but you'll always be Valor and Zale to me. Wouldn't want it any other way. Seriously, we did something good here. You guys are the best. Well, go on then, and don't you ever miss my birthday. You can count on it. Promise? Promise. Well, we should... yeah, and then she's like, I need the story, because I'm better older. Took her longer to get here. I actually wonder what his moves are, but hey. Outplayed. You stupid, bro. Delaying their attacks is just so broken. It's so good. Same. Please stay safe. It's not about us. We got memories. Time to go, blah, blah, blah. Do we have to do that fucking section again? I guess we do it again. Kind of weird we do it twice, but hey, whatever. I'll save the plasma beam. shit bum. Man, I wonder if this is like leading them to like make an actual bullet hell game. Again, I'm down for it. Fuck it. Plasma beam. Now I did it without taking damage. Yeah, cool. All right, let's see. I have the same comments I had before. Game is still fantastic. It goes by 20 points because Garl is alive. So this game receives a negative, like, 19 or whatever the fuck. I don't know. It deserves it. They fucking bring back Garl. You get a fucking negative points on my number scale. You deserve it. Oh, this one's new. What's he doing? What are you doing? Yeah, so while these cutscenes are going, let me make sure that I find... it says Devroom Easter Egg? Yeah, okay, so I think this is it. Alright, so it says Flimsy Hammer 1, 2, then it goes to the Easter egg. Okay, so we'll... let's just make sure that I get to where it starts. Yeah, okay, so you go in here. Alright, so it starts here, yeah, okay. And we'll switch this up, well, yeah, we'll bring this here. We'll get rid of all this, get rid of that. Make that full screen, and then we'll bring this back. Okay, there we go. All right, cool. No thumbnail spoiler, so. Did I do the spa day? Yes, I did. I didn't do it with Garl, because fuck him. He doesn't get to. Oh, look at him. Oh, yeah, get him, cut him, shit him up, yeah. Oh, wow, he's still standing. Yeah, that dude's ridiculous. I want him at my party. Yeah, I've done it with everybody except for Garl. And they all get, like, ridiculous, like, buff stats and shit. It's sick. Why does it feel like I have an indent right here? That's just my bald ass head, bro. I like how my camera is still like freezing every 2 seconds. I need to figure out what the deal is with that. Sometimes it does it, sometimes it doesn't. I really don't know what causes it. It's really annoying. Maybe I should like make sure that it goes into like one of the better ports. I'm pretty sure I have it in 3.0, but whatever. Yeah, no, on the for realsies, this game still gets a 9.5. Even after the true ending stuff, yeah. Adds a little bit extra so you can get your favorite fucking character back. Yeah, whoopee, yay. Ooh. That's a cool still. Alright. Alright, let's see. Alright, so far it looks the same. So we gather it each year because I'm an old lady.
Okay. So far, it's all the same. The statues are a little bit different. How's the progress? Pretty good. Looking at the flood. Blah, blah, blah. And there he is, yeah. Yes, it's perfect. Ha. You'll be late if you don't leave soon. Oops. Yeah, I guess I should head out. I will say that old Garl looks the best, for sure, out of all the designs. Hey, old friend. Happy birthday, Master. For the millionth time, please stop calling me that. Are you ready to go then? Oh yeah, can't be late. Yeah, at least old Garl looks cool. Oh, okay, yeah, they're back to their hiding spot. Just right. Ha, right on time. Yeah, of course they're looking the same. Oh, come on, don't be shy now. That's cute. Man, if you like Garl, this would be a really great ending. Since I hate this, this ending sucks. Just kidding. Oh, there you go. Okay, so you get the true... That's how you get the other one. Okay. And back to the title card. Yeah! Sea of Stars is done! Woo! Whoopee! What a fucking great game. What a fucking fantastic game. Fucking, again, knock it right out of the park. Same thing like Messenger. It's fucking fantastic. I do love this game. Alright. Let's see. Let's see what this extra thing is. Is it worth doing all the fucking things? Alright, so you get the Easter egg. Apparently you go here and you interact with this thing. And you push that to the side. Smash. Smash. Oh, you straight up, like, have to use, like, each one. Yeah, okay. This guy's already worse because he's using, Zales, like, as the main character. Lower that a bit. Alright. Okay. That's the last one, yeah? You motherfuckers. You motherfuckers. You gotta hear that fucking music. You gotta hear that fucking music, baby. Hang on a minute. Run that shit back. Run that shit back. And that is actually the wardrobe too. Look at that. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's so cool. Oh, it's so good. The shopkeeper's the fucking best, dude. Have we met before? Well, if we have and you're about to complain about some time paradox, maybe consider that it was you who just broke the fourth wall. Nice. The shopkeeper's the fucking best, dude. You're probably not getting a raise either, but the cabinet's all yours if you want to knock yourself out. What the fuck? Office hours? Ever since those Solstice kids came around, no one can really tell the time of day. I hope you can I hope we could show you something new on this journey back to our childhoods. Actually, a dev room. Oh, wow. That's cool. Yo, I'm Reese, and I play acoustic instruments. I don't really know how I got here, but hot dog, am I glad to be a part of this rad game. Also, feel free to mail me a hot dog. Wow. Feel free to mail me a glizzy. I'm Jake. I helped Eric with the music and sound effects. This is the first game I've ever worked on, and I couldn't have asked to be a part of a better team. Dude, fucking shout-outs to Jake. First game ever, and you made this fucking killer soundtrack, dude? This dude's ridiculous. Shout-outs to Jake. Fuck yeah. I'm JP, an integrator. I used to find bugs, but now I fix them, and also cause them. I don't know, I'm not a mechanic. Yeah. Jean-Philippe. I hope I made things move in a way that moved you. Hey, and the wall? Huh? Oh, I'm Greg. The squirrels will tell you different, but I'm an animator. Don't listen to their squeaky whispers. They tell lies. I don't know what that means. And there's the demon. There's the actual messenger. Yeah, dude. Oh, that's great. I like how they have that pixelated. Now that would be a great buzzword for a graphics feature. Laughs in HLSL. Don't know what that means. So I'm not really familiar with that verbiage. It was not an easy task making all this, but I'm incredibly proud of everyone in here. I hope you enjoyed it. Dude, there's not enough games that do this anymore. Like, that get you, like, a fucking, like, dev room or some, like, out-of-fucking-place shit. Like, there's nothing that's like this in games no more, dude. I'm so blessed as a community manager. Oh, why'd you make that so fast? The CSR's community is simply the best, don't you think? Am I speaking to the player or Zale? Or, I guess, Valor in my case. In any case, hope you had fun discovering the world. I hope you enjoyed the game as much as I think I would have if I didn't get it spoiled by working on it. man, that's good. There's a lot of people here. Oh, that is it. Like actually, like a whole like a whole division. If you want to pretend the characters are having dance offs instead of fighting, I give you my official animator permission. Wow, fair enough. Now that I think about it, it was a really fun journey being a part of this production. I think we ended up with a pretty cool game. Do you agree? This textbook should be nudged half a pixel to the left. I'm so proud I got to be part of this amazing team. I enjoyed composing for Sea of Stars. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I hope you enjoyed the nostalgic music. Yeah, so fucking... I'm out of the characters. Out of all the characters I helped to create, Conan is my favorite. His mom gets most of the credit, though. Whoa, have you seen all those animations? I'm so proud of what we accomplished. Mercy, Terry. I'll miss the production, but getting some sleep will be nice. Did you have fun playing? The team worked really hard on making it as good as possible. You guys sure fucking did. What a slam dunk. There's more guys over there? Yeah, okay. Oh, the puppy! Buddy stares softly, relieving a tightness in your chest you didn't even know was there. If you could pet the dog, that would have been the best. Now, where do I put that thing again? I sincerely hope that we were able to communicate the love we have for games through the Sea of Stars experience. I'm Oliver from Berserk. I coded mostly under the hood stuff, but I also managed the publishing of the game. If you're playing, it means we did it. Yay! Hope you enjoy it. Or Olivier, I guess. Not Oliver. I'm the one finding the bugs now. What do you say? That JP is causing them. Oh, nice. Around the age of 6, I fell in love with RPGs after playing FF1 and decided this is what I wanted to do when I grew up. 30 years later, and with the best team ever, my childhood dream has come true. Carl! You made Carl! hey, I animate a few characters, and then I started blowing them up instead. Sorry about all the explosions you took to the face. Eric's the name. Music and audio design is the game. For the game, it's my own game within the game. This game, in fact. Oh no, help, I'm trapped inside the game. Hey, I'm Maiko. I created the visuals for the environments in our games. Did you enjoy discovering all the vistas? Aw. Yeah, man. Time to finally uninstall Sea of Stars. 40 hours. Whew. Fucking great game. Fucking claps all around. Well, that is the best. There's another part. They robbed you. Uh-oh. All right, so hold on. Let's see. There was more. I guess dev room. Sea of Stars dev room. Oh, you get to go back and talk to him. Oh shit. Never mind. I was about to say, we're about to wrap up. Oh shit. Well, look at you. You made it to the end. What? You did it all. It's over. You just met the actual team. What more do you want? The show's over. I'm going to bed, and so should you. Ugh! It's so good! It's so good! Alright, you want to hear a rant? Yes! 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 Yes, 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 yes! Let's go! Are you sure? There's no cutting me off. Fine. So you beat the game. Did you like it? Did the show steal itself? Did it do everything you wanted? And more importantly, was it worth your time? Would you say the team created some content here, or are you reserving that term for those who will play it in front of a virtual crowd? Okay, let's start slow. Congratulations, you defeated all the bosses. You resurrected your best friend. You found all the rainbow conches. You fished all the fish. You wheeled all the wheels. Oh my god, this is the best. You quizzed all the quizzes. Last time I tried being boring, I ended up making friends who thought we needed more products using Alpha and Omega in their marketing. I'm not about to risk that happening again, so let's move on to talking about an absolute, shall we? To make a good video game, you need to have grass in the first area, lava close to the fake ending, and a secret boss that's harder than the final boss. Look, I do make the rules. You can either disagree or take some notes. For what it's worth, I hope you disagree though, if only for the irony of you standing here right now after having turned every stone. If you find me annoying already, just consider that it's not like healthy sleep schedules come easy for me. Also, I don't brush my teeth at work after lunch. I mean, who does that? I consider myself quite bearable, in fact. Anyway, thanks for the warm-up. I'll be here if you feel like getting real. Still here? I've got more if you want, but it goes a bit deeper. Are you absolutely sure? There's no cutting me off, and I tend to ramble. Okay, you asked. You know the kind of people who use a niche word they just learned as if everyone knew what it was, but it's really only so someone will ask them to explain it? That used to get to me. Like there was some injustice in people earning points through manipulation and lying by omission. But let me tell you one perk about getting older. You start seeing the later chapters of some stories, and they have a lot to teach. Then one day, the realization just hit me. A lot of people are part of a race where no one even knows what they're trying to win. And I don't know what the supposed prize is either. I just know that I don't want it. It was kind of freeing to realize that there can't be anything of substance in a game that doesn't value integrity. Now, all I feel towards that is slight disappointment when I think of the friendships that I could have made. But nothing too disappointing. Just kind of like noticing that the bread contains raisins. Okay. So that's what I do now. I avoid raisin bread without engaging, and it's something I wish I'd started doing decades ago. Are you still with me? I'll save the rest of the real talk for the final part in case this is your stop. There won't be any judgment from this side in any case. Let's tone it down by talking about music. You ever go to a metal show where the musicians paint their faces? I used to think they were just exaggerating their character to play the crowd. And while I'm sure there's plenty for whom that's the reason, it also dawned on me that some probably just need a persona. Something that they can become in order to remove whatever insecurities that would prevent them from engaging in pure expression. Something that provides just enough of a sense of being hidden to tap into a healthy form of anonymity, the empowering kind. Sort of how, like, wearing sunglasses can remove the extra layer of social anxiety that comes from eye contact. To be honest, I've lost count of how many times sunglasses allow me to say no in public. Anyway, so about those metal shows. It's not lost on me that I might just be imagining all this, that maybe they are all like the aesthetics and that's all there is to it. But they still played an important role in letting me believe in the benefits of personas, and in picturing a viable path of expressing myself. If that sounds confusing, the point of that, any interpretation of an artist's work is valid, though it may not represent the artist's intentions. If that still sounds confusing, you can replace painting your face with building a virtual world for all your made-up characters to live in. And if that still sounds confusing, the point is that I like this cloak. He is just the best. He is just the best. He is the best. I have to go soon, but we can do one more round if you want. He is the best, dude. Do you want me to get real? Are you absolutely sure? I can't guarantee it won't ruin the game for you. Garl already ruins it, so... Okay. With this whole time traveling business, my memory tends to play tricks on me. I don't remember whether or not we've met before, but if we have, you might be wondering how the boy from the well is doing. The boy from the well? The short answer is that he's doing better, but I suppose we're here for a long answer, so let's do a short recap. The story so far. There once was a little boy stuck in a well. It wasn't really clear why he was in there. People assumed he felt like playing, or that someone had pushed him. In truth, he had jumped in there himself. He spent years in the well, wasting away anxiously, feeling utterly inadequate. He had a deep desire to share his ideas with the world, but shame having played such a big part in his upbringing, his will lay broken. That's why the well suited him so perfectly, a place to hide, where he could be alone with his stories, with no one to mock or judge him. It was a safe line. Unfortunately devoid of purpose, but at least shielded from rejection. Over the years, he made friends who helped him climb out, and helped him build his stories to share them with the world. His friends were very talented indeed, and together they earned the means to keep collaborating in their own shared space. And that, in short, is why this story ended 5 years ago. A lot has happened since then, and this journey wouldn't feel whole without some closure, so here we go. Cloak on... Wait, what did it say? Cloak on, mask off. It dawned on him somewhere during year 2 out of 5 of production that for all of the sorrow inside him, there was still hate. Not the externalized kind, but the kind that is directed towards the self, a crippling sense of unworthiness. It had festered into a false promise that with enough effort, something would rise from the ashes. I forgot to pause it. At long last. A belief that the entire world just might be enough for two people to finally see that all along they'd have something worth welcoming, worth accepting. But how would that even play out exactly? Learning about the notion of healing fantasies completely floored him. His situation ticked all the boxes. Life simply didn't work that way. There could be no click moment for abusers, and certainly no travel back in time to set things right. All that was left was a future, and while some wounds may heal over time, there was a lot of doors, happy doors, that would remain shut forever. For months, it all turned into fear. Fear of being nothing but a response. Fear of living in delusion that he was sticking to those who had broken him, while in reality was still dancing for them. Getting out of his way to work around the clock, constantly keeping the plates spinning as if there was a point or an end to it all. He had burned those bridges a long time ago, so why do their bidding still? And what was he thinking anyway, exposing the imaginary world he had used in order to survive for everyone to judge and criticize? And so he crashed, but not so much in a physical way. It was like emotionally falling asleep, slowly but surely, until he felt next to nothing. But the work continued, for it was the only thing that kept him going. And with every passing day, he would routinely close the blinds on the rising sun to prevent the glare from creeping up on his screen. Going through the motions, the work progressed, and progressed well, but he was losing his grip on reality. During year 4, the guardian he never knew he had reappeared, and she saved him one last time. His grandmother was dying, but in her final days found exactly the words that would give him purpose and substance. It washed over him in an instant. She had been there in the background all his life, a loving and caring presence, the much-needed light in all the darkness. The foundation she had managed to build within him in the limited time they had spent together during his childhood was carrying him to this day. Thank you, Irene. I love you. Or Irene. He finally understood that to touch everything with gloves was to touch nothing but gloves. Wow. Oh, wow, good. So he took them off and let the memories flow. Riding his bicycle through a puddle of water to mark the road with the wet there. Going through the box of popsicles at his friend's pace, and trying to see through the wrapper to avoid the orange ones. Feeling so thirsty that he liked to imagine that the first sip only served to give him the energy he needed to chug the glass. And of course, video games. He finally understood what they had been to him, a sanctuary. The place where he could be free, free to experiment, to learn, to ask, to fail, to preserve, to give up, to overcome, to laugh, to accomplish, to dream. He wasn't just a response. He was someone who understood how to build a sanctuary, and who knew what it was like to need one. There had to be others, people who he would never meet, who needed a place like he had known, so he had to make it the best he could. And in a flash, he saw it anew, something that was right there in plain sight all along, the unbelievable talent that gathered to bring this vision to life. The sudden realization made him uncomfortable at first, thinking about how vulnerable he had allowed himself to be in front of his teammates over the years. But for all his second thoughts, there was one thing he couldn't deny, that they were still there. Each and every one of them listening mindfully every day, plying their craft to help build something they could all be proud of. And at long last, he knew that everything he needed, he already possessed. His friends were there with him. They always had been. This whole journey was one of genuine expression of their personalities and of their unbelievable chemistry. With all thoughts of destruction now gone, he set out to complete the project with the intention to create without any hope of recognition. The abusers wouldn't win, not anymore. He was pursuing this because he sincerely wanted to, and he had backup. Now with a stronger sense of self, he also took note never to fly so close to the sun again. I wish I could tell you that he achieved balance and now lives a life with more than a single thing occupying all of his time, but on that, only time will tell. Thank you for helping me indulge in some closure. It was much needed. I'll be going now. Papate.
Oh, that's right. I was like, who is that from the ending, from the true ending? He's from the Messenger. That's right. This boss. That's right. Oh! I figured that was a studio lead, yeah. Thank you so much for watching the prequel to The Messenger, Sea of Stars. If you haven't played The Messenger, go play The Messenger. If you like what you've seen, please play Sea of Stars. I highly recommend playing both, especially now. This is probably going to be now stuck in my top three, now that I got it. Is it going to be my game of the year, though? I don't know. But man, what a fucking ride. And thank you for tuning in with me. To announce it, I will, the next game I'll be playing is going to be Alan Wake. I will start that probably the next stream. I'm not doing Alan Wake 2, not anytime soon. Haven't actually done Alan Wake 1. So we're going to go through that. And that'll hopefully give us enough time to get through the rest of the year. I might have one more game in addition to that. Maybe. No guarantees, though, because going to be close to cutting it at the end of the year. And the end of the year is going to be, like, tough because I'm going away for the remainder of, like, the half of the month. So, yeah, Alan Wake will be next. And I might have something in between that, too. And, of course, we'll continue with Devil May Cry, with my one and only, hopefully before we leave for Germany. And yeah, and then we're going to have an end of the year stream to go over the my favorite game of the year. And maybe a giveaway at the end of the year or something. Who knows? But yeah. That's going to do it for me, though. Sea of Stars. Yeah. Love this game. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out, guys. See you guys next time.